In the previous videos, we implemented a perceptron algorithm, which was hopefully a very fun exercise. However, we skipped over the important topic of model evaluation. So let's at least cover the basics. So in this video, we will focus on the fundamentals and introduce more concepts later on. And one of the big fundamentals of model evaluation is to use separate datasets for training and evaluation. So consider we are given a training dataset for classification. And since it's a classification dataset, we also have the corresponding labels. To make this more concrete, consider this dataset where we have 14 training data points, and the first 7 training data points belong to class 0, and the second 7 training points belong to class 1. So first, we have to shuffle our dataset. Note that when we shuffle the dataset, the correspondence between training example and label still remains intact. Then once we shuffled the dataset, we can divide the dataset into a training dataset and a test dataset. If we haven't shuffled our dataset, the problem would be that all the test data points would be from class 1. So we can hopefully see that shuffling is actually often important. Now we can use the training dataset to train our model, and we can use the separate test dataset to evaluate the performance of our trained model. It is strongly recommended to only use the test set once, at the very end, once we have our final model. That is to keep the model evaluation unbiased. However, in typical workflows, what happens is that we often have to tweak certain parameters of our model. So for that, we also introduce an additional validation set. So this validation set, you can think of it as an additional split off from the training data set. In other words, we use the training data set to train the model, and we use the validation set to tune our model. And we will see later how this works in practice. Again, the reason why we use multiple data sets is that we want to get a precise or accurate estimation of our model performance. Because one problem that often occurs in machine learning is overfitting. So overfitting means that the model fits the training data too closely. So if we would use the training data set to evaluate the performance of our model, our performance estimate might be actually better than it really is. Because really we want to know how well our model performs on new data. The test and the validation data acts as a proxy for this new data. So here in this plot, we visualize the model performance for different training set sizes. Here, the higher the model performance, the better. So for instance, this could be the model prediction accuracy. Often when we have a very small training data set, we will get a very high training performance or a high training accuracy. And that is because it's easy to fit small data sets. Often the larger the data set becomes, the harder it will be for the model to memorize this data set. So usually what we observe is for larger data sets, the training performance becomes slightly worse. On the other hand, what we really care about though is the performance on new data, which we measure by the test or validation sets. So the larger the data set, typically the easier it is to train a model without overfitting. So here in this plot, we are visualizing the effect of overfitting, which is really the gap between training and test set performance. And typically for machine learning and especially deep learning models, the larger the data set, the better. While the training set performance may go down, what we really care about is how the model performs on new data. So we can see here in this plot that the test and validation accuracy actually improves as we improve the training data set size. So this plot highlights the problem of overfitting and relates the training performance to the test and validation set performance. However, how do we actually compute the performance precisely? That is something we will cover in the next video.